Hello everyone. Today I've got this new technology, the technology of the screen recording. And using this screen recording, I'm just going to start the new section of the literature part. And this section is the poetry section. And I will start a very important and very famous poem, Keeping Quiet. This poem is written by Ricardo Elisha Neftali Reis Bosalato. Okay, I'm just repeating. Ricardo Elisha Neftali Reis Basalto. Basalto. Okay, this name is a French name, and because of this so much longer name, this poet has adopted a very short name, which is Pablo Neruda. So this poem, Keeping Quiet, is written by Pablo Neruda. Pablo Neruda was a poet, diplomat, and senator also. Senator means the person who has got the membership in American Parliament. Okay, so he was a senator, he was a diplomat, politician, poet. So this kind of personality always writes those kind of things which is very relevant for the human beings and the humanity also. And the poem Keeping Quiet is one of them. In this poem, you will see that the brotherhood, the theme of the brotherhood, love, and peace, which the poet had tried to spray among the people. Okay, the details of life and work of the poet, I will prepare a page, and in that page you will receive all kind of detail related with this poet Pablo Neruda. So here I am going to start the explanation of the poem. Okay, in this explanation I am just going to explain the poem line by line. Okay, so in my explanation I will start from the very first line of the poem, which you are just having on your screen. Students, keeping quiet means to keep quiet, to be silent. And this poet, from the very first line, is just sticking with his thought. He is just having his thought, in which he is saying, now we will count to 12 and we will all keep still. The poet is saying that he is going to count up to 12 and he is requesting everyone, he is advising to everyone to keep still. For once on the face of the earth, let's not speak in any language. Let's stop for 1 second and not move our arms so much. In the very first four lines, the stanza of the four line, the poet is talking about the stillness. The poet is talking about to enjoy the stillness in the place of the rush. The poet is speaking to stop the unnecessary rush, and he is just trying to spray the message of the brotherhood, peace, and humanity. So he is just saying that we should not speak any language and we should be still, be quiet for a second, for 1 second. Next four line, it would be an exotic movement without the rush, without engines, we would all be together in a sudden strangeness. Suppose this kind of things happen, then everything is just stop, the engines are stop, the rush, the running, behind the so many work, then if everything is stopped, the condition of the lockdown. Yeah, this is the poet is talking about a lockdown. Yeah, indirectly, this poem is very much relevant with the present context. Yeah, so the poet is talking about to stop the unnecessary rush, to stop the engines, and then there will be a strange movement. As you know that when the lockdown has started in our country, then we were feeling a different type of world. We have experienced a different kind of things. So the poet is saying that would be an exotic movement. If this happens, then everyone stops the rushing and running, then it would be an exotic movement. And in that exotic moment, we will think about ourselves. Okay? In the next stanza, the poet is saying, fishermen in the cold sea would not harm whales, and the man gathering salt would look at his hot hands. Okay? The poet is saying that no fisherman will harm any kind of whales. Here whales means the unharmful people, because whale is a very unharmful animal, water animal, okay, and that is not so dangerous also, okay, that's a very friendly animal, whales, and quiet and like a giant animal, gentle animal, okay. So the poet is saying that fishermen must stop to just harming the whales, and the people who are gathering salt. Gathering salt means the people who are engaged in a very hard work, just stop and think about the hot hands. Means the people who are engaged in the salt work, salt making work, their hands are so damaged. So the poet is saying that they should stop their damaging work, which is just damaging their body, and they must think about their body. Students, in the next line, the poet is speaking about those who prepare green wars with gas, wars with fire, victory with no survivor, would put on clean clothes and walk about their brothers. Okay, the poet is here advocating to stop every unnecessary work which is just harming the human beings and the environment and the people's life. So the poet is saying to stop every kind of wars. The poet is indicating those kind of things like a war, okay, and the poet is saying that to stop that kind of things for a while and put on a new cloth means to take a new type of attitude in themselves. And when this new attitude, like a peace, to help everyone, brotherhood, this kind of attitude is called the new clothes, clean clothes. So when the people will wear the clean clothes means when the people will have this kind of friendly activity and attitude for the everyone, then the in the shade doing nothing, when the people will do nothing, and then they will think about the humanity. Students, I am just taking your mind in the context of lockdown. In the lockdown period, we all try to help each other. If you have not done this thing, then I am not sure. But personally, I also try to help everyone. I try to help the people who are engaged in the cleanliness work. Even personally, I am just thanking him. We are thanking द पीपल हु आर एंगेज इन हेल्थ सेक्टर लाइक डॉक्टर्स नर्सेज वी आर हेल्पिंग द पीपल हु आर इन पुलिस डिपार्टमेंट वी आर थैंकिंग दैम दैट मीन्स वेन वी विल स्टिल वी विल सिट टूगेदर एंड वी विल थिंक अबाउट द पीस एंड द ह्यूमैनिटी वी विल सी दैट सो मैनी पीपल आर डूइंग अ वेरी ग्रेट जॉब एंड वी विल थिंक वी विल टेक दैट देम एज अ ब्रदर एज अ आवर सेवियर हेयर द पोएट वॉन्ट्स टू मेक क्लियर दैट वॉट आई वॉन्ट शुड बी कन्फ्यूज वॉट आई वॉन्ट शुड नॉट बी कन्फ्यूज विथ टोटल इनएक्टिविटी द पोएट इज सेंग दैट देयर टोटल इनएक्टिविटी द पोएट इज सेंग दैट टोटल इनएक्टिविटी बट इन द वेरी नेक्स्ट लाइन द पोएट इज एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट लाइफ इज वॉट इट इज अबाउट लाइफ इज वॉट इट इज अबाउट एंड लाइफ मीन्स लाइफ मस्ट बी लाइक अ रिवर इट मस्ट फ्लो एंड वेन इट विल स्टॉप दैट मीन्स इट विल बी लाइक अ डेथ सो द पोएट इज एक्सप्लेनिंग हिज व्यू द पोएट इज मेकिंग क्लियर दैट लाइफ इज वॉट इट इज अबाउट मीन्स लाइफ मस्ट गो ऑन एंड आई वॉन्ट नो ट्रक विथ डेथ द पोएट इज अगेन सेइंग दैट ही इज नॉट एडवोकेटिंग टू गेट द डेथ इफ वी वर नॉट सो सिंगल माइंडेड अबाउट कीपिंग आवर लाइव्स मूविंग एंड फॉर वंस कुड डू नथिंग सपोज इफ वी विल थिंक अबाउट द सिंगल माइंडेडली then we will not understand what the poet is trying to say. The poet is trying to say to stop the all unnecessary work. All the unnecessary work must be stopped at the right moment. Okay, and this is the right moment to stop all unnecessary work. And stopping unnecessary work doesn't mean to stop everything. Okay, so the poet is just interpreting that we must stop the unnecessary work right now. Okay, here he is clearing, if we were not so single-minded about keeping our lives moving and for once could do nothing, okay, for once could do nothing, perhaps a huge silence might interrupt in this sadness. This silence will bring the sadness of never understanding ourselves. So, don't think this poem from the single mind. Okay? When you will try to understand this poem in a very single-mindedly, then you will not understand that what the poet is trying to say. The poet is trying to say that life must go on. Life is what it is about. Okay? And he is not advocating the death. He is just saying to stop all unnecessary work. Even he is just giving the example of earth as a teacher. See, in the second last stanza, perhaps the earth can teach us as when everything seems dead and later proves to be alive. What is earth? We never think about the earth. We are just doing our work and we think that earth is dead. It has no pain, it has no life. But when we think that this earth, this land is dead, then in the very next moment, we see that some new life is coming from the earth. Means the life of the tree, life of the plants are coming out from the earth. So the earth is teaching us that total inactivity doesn't mean the death. You must keep the life inside yourself. And stop all unnecessary thing what you are doing. Okay, now I'll count up to 12 in the last two lines couplet. When the two lines are given, that must be called couplet. So in the last two line couplet, and now I'll count up to 12. The poet has explained everything. So he is just going to count 12 and you keep quiet and I will go. You will keep quiet. So student here up to 12, the poet will count up to 12. So 12 means the 12 hours of the day. The 12 means the 12 month of the year, everything. What you can take and what kind of So here 12 means the 12 month of the year. So 12 month, the poet will count up to 12 month, and everyone will accept this kind of life in which the unnecessary rush, unnecessary demands must be stopped, and only the things which can express the beauty of the life. The beauty of life is hidden in brotherhood, peace, humanity, love, and the people who can express this kind of beauty of the life must be assured and must be keep started. So here the poem ends. Student, I have explained this poem using the new technology, and I have liked this new technology. If you have liked, then you must message me. I am very desperate. I am very desperate from your attitude. So many of you have not participated in the article writing competition. I am very desperate, and I cannot see. If you will not work, then I will not be able to work and express my thought in front of you. This is very bad. You are doing nothing. You are the student of standard 12, and keep one thing in your mind: everything, every classes will be stopped, but the 10 and the 12 classes, 10 and the 12 classes will not be stopped. Okay, the exam of the 10 and 12 classes must be go on, and you are the student of board. We will not take your examination, and we will not promote you in the next class and in the examination. Your copy will be checked by the other people, so you will have to read, because life is what it is about. And a student of the standard 10 and the standard 12 is like in the activity which can't be stopped. We can stop, we can change the syllabus of standard 11, 9, 8, 7, 6, everything, but what the syllabus will be designed for you, you will have to attempt that. And this poem can't be replaced by any poem. This is a very important poem, and I have told you I am just taking those poems, those chapters which will not be ignored when the new syllabus will be formed. Okay, this is enough for the today's class. I hope you have liked my today's class. I will prepare the summary of this poem, and I will send you in the PDF format. My homework is to do the answer of the 4 questions what you can see on the screen, and send me the images of your answer in my personal number. Okay, have a nice day.